That's what we read in the book of Proverbs 28, verse 13. He who covers up one's sin will not prosper. If you recognize your sin, repent for your sin, and you determine to leave away the sin, God's grace will enter into you. That's what we read in 2 Chronicles 7:14. All those who come in my name, if they bow down, humble themselves, and acknowledge their sin, and give away their sin, I will forgive their sins from heaven. And I will empower them with my power from heaven. And I will heal their nations. Yes, still God is with them. God is calling them, come back to me. Now take a decision to move with God. My dear friends, in the gospel also, we read the same thing. In John's gospel, chapter 8, verse 12, which is the gospel acclamation today, I am the light of the world. He who follows me, number one, they will not become victim of the darkness. Number two, they will have the light of life. So when we have the crisis, we can cling to the crisis and ask ourselves, what's happening to me? Or in every crisis, we look unto the Lord and say, where God is leading us to? What God is doing through us? What is the mission in which God is leading us to? So he says, if you look unto me, if you follow me, I am the light of the world. So if you follow me, number one, I will protect you from the darkness. You will not fall into the trap of darkness. Number two, you will experience my life, my power, my vision for which you belong to. So every crisis is calling us to be alert, not to become victim to the enemy, means not to allow yourself to the mind game of getting discouraged or disappointed or speak the language of the enemy and being bitten by the snake, but rather look unto the Lord, take up the challenge, and become men and women who witness to God, moving with the power and grace of God. So the Lord is saying, you will look for me and not move with me. This is the crisis we have. In John 8:21, today's gospel, Jesus says, you will look for me, but you will not move with me, and you will die in your sin. Many people come to God to look for God. They are coming to God that God should remove their crisis. God should remove their problem. Prayer means God helping them to come out of their problems. But God says prayer means being with God and knowing the purpose of God and surrendering oneself, offering oneself into the hands of God, that God may fulfill his mission in us. I repeat, man thinks prayer means coming to God and get the help from God and to come out of the crisis, come out of the problem. But God is saying prayer means coming to the Lord even in those moments of crisis and move with God, means life is to be in the hands of God and allow God to teach us why this crisis, what is he doing in this crisis, and where does he lead us to, and to be in the hands of God and allow oneself into the hands of God to be used by God. So don't move with a thought of what you are going through, but rather move your mind to the thought of God, to the plan of God. Let heaven be part of you who are on this earth. I love to share with you this small incident which happened in 1 Samuel chapter 9, verse 19 to 21, Saul was searching for his donkey. And he goes to the prophet called Samuel. And the prophet Samuel says, God wants you to come and meet him tomorrow. And as for your donkeys, they are already met. And God will fulfill what is in your heart. What is in the heart of Samuel? He longs to be a king. He went around searching for his donkey and he saw the beautiful land. He said, how can I be the leader? If I possess all these things, I can do this, I can do that. He was creating. He's a vision builder. God is looking for people, a vision builders. Who am I in the Lord? What I can do for the Lord? And God is looking for people who are vision, moved with visions, and God will use them. That's why the prophet tells, tomorrow you come, God will teach you, tell you what is in your heart. But as for your donkeys, which you are searching, it's already found. Don't hold on to the donkeys which are lost and lose sight of the destiny which God is preparing for you. The great vision God has kept for you. Let not the clouds of donkeys, the clouds of what we have lost in life, lose sight of what God has kept for us. The great destiny to be the king over the people of Israel. So God said to Saul through Samuel, what is in your heart? You long to be the king. Keep alive that vision. God is looking for people who are willing to take the challenge, who are willing to see God's light in darkness, who are willing to see what God tells us in this crisis and move with God. Move with the vision of God. Move with the power of God. And bring God's power to this world which is dying. And lead the world with the power of God. And that's what we read in verse 23. Jesus says, John 8, 23. Hello, my dear, you are from below. And you are the worldly thinking is attacking you. But I am from above. I am bringing you godly thinking. Only with godly thinking, with the light of heaven, you can handle the crisis of this earth. And verse 26, he says, he who sent me is reliable. So move with God. See, the Father sent me and he is always with me. He has never left me. And he has been successful. So follow me, you will have never allow the darkness to overcome you, and you can enjoy the light which God gives to you. So move with him. Let not your life become crying how to come out of the problem, but how to move with God and bring God to this world. That's why in verse 29, he says, my Father is always with me. He has never left me. In verse 28 says, but when you lift me up, you will know that I give life even on the cross. You will lift me up. You will crucify me. But what the persecution or the problems one faces cannot stop me in giving life even on the cross. So the cross, the pain, the suffering the world gives to us cannot stop what God has designed for us. If we move with the light of God, if we move with God, yes,